All Pro Wrestling fans, John Roberts, joined by my broadcast colleague, Matthew Thiel, here to call this All Pro Wrestling Gym Wars action. And we're starting off this morning with Mr. Wrestling number 4 taking on the internet sensation, Brandon P.Net.
That was close. That was really good, John Roberts. Matthew Thiel, very correct. But in the future, Matthew Thiel, the greatest mind in professional wrestling, I believe is my full title. So keep that in mind.
Well, you can see clips of the self-proclaimed greatest mind in professional wrestling, Matthew Thiel, on YouTube.com/AllProWrestling as he's managing his mountain from Stone Mountain, Larry Blackwell. It's all over YouTube.com/AllProWrestling, as well as all your favorite pro wrestling stars from All Pro Wrestling.
Now, someone else that I've had a very close eye on is in this young man here, Brandon P.Net. Been in a couple of matches here at APW. Biggest opponent, I believe, so far against Mr. Wrestling number 4. We'll see how well he does.
That's right. The former worldwide internet champion here in All Pro Wrestling, Mr. Wrestling number 4. And he's just going to go ahead and grapple away here against Brandon P.Net in the early going, taking him down to the mat.
We'll also have to see how well Brandon P. does because he's just coming back from an injury.
Well, you know more about that injury than I do. Would you like to elaborate on that?
Yeah, sure. Why not? All right. Brandon P.Net, I believe he hurt his shoulder. It's healed. He's back in the ring.
There
we go.
Beautiful snapmare right there. Not showing any signs of fatigue in that shoulder. And now he's got a sleeper hold applied in the center of the ring. He's bringing Mr. Wrestling number 4 shoulders down. Number 4 almost found himself in a pinning predicament there. Instead, he rolls all the way through, floats over, and now finds himself in a front face lock. Brandon P.Net finds himself in a front face lock from Mr. Wrestling number 4.
Man, I can't get a word in edgewise with you today, John. Robert's starting off really early with the monologues. You saw earlier Mr. Wrestling number 4 now trying to shimmy his way out of this, but he was adjusting his mask. That's a downside of wearing a mask in the ring there. Sure, you hide your identity, you can't get stalked by the bad guys, but it could also be a deterrent. I mean, cover the eyes. Can't see, can't wrestle. It's very bad.
That's right. Well, Brandon P.Net's also got that bandana around his head. He finds himself in a pinning predicament there. Gets the shoulder back up into a bridge. Again, back down on the shoulders. Tom Caster right there to count. The senior official here in APW. And now it looks like Brandon's going to try to get to a vertical base, and he does so. But Mr. Wrestling number 4 not letting go of the control on the wrist as he maintains control on that hold. Spinning Brandon P.Net around the ring, and P.Net showing some great cruiserweight athleticism there as he rolls all the way through, flips up, kips up back onto his feet, and now takes control of the wrist of Mr. Wrestling number 4.
Well, that's the second long monologue of the day, John Roberts. Congratulations.
Well, a cover of number by number 4 only gets a one count.
You need to keep in mind, though, there's insight that I also have to offer to these matches, Mr. Roberts. I don't have any at this time, but I might in the future.
Well, if you do, you know feel free to chime in. This is All Pro Wrestling, home of some of the greatest, if not the greatest, pro wrestling you will ever see anywhere. Luthez press right there for Mr. Wrestling number 4. Flings away the bandana of Brandon P.Net right towards our camera, and he's back up to his feet, shimmying his way along in the ring. Ducks a clothesline there, and a beautiful maneuver from Mr. Wrestling number 4. Rolls through with the cover, only gets the two count.
The disrespect, Mr. Wrestling number 4. Mr. Wrestling number 4 showed Brandon P.Net there. It was absolutely disgusting, John Roberts. Taking an article of clothing off of Brandon P., something that he holds dear. He wears that bandana every time he goes into the ring with those green shorts, and he just throws it in the audience like he doesn't care.
Well, a big backbreaker there. Looking for a cover, only gets two. Almost had the pinfall there. But the match continues, and you see P.Net rolling over. And now Mr. Wrestling number 4 going to bring Brandon back up to a vertical base. And a side Russian leg sweep brings him all the way back down again. Mr. Wrestling number 4 going to go up to the second rope. Looking for that flying headbutt. Nobody home. P.Net rolls out of the way. The internet sensation, probably out of desperation, rolling towards the ropes. And now both men are down in the center of the ring.
Brandon P.Net maybe showing a little bit of ring rust. He's able to get out of the way just in time from that diving headbutt. But Mr. Wrestling number 4 has been in control of this match throughout most of it. Yes, Mr. Wrestling number 4 is a great talent in there. He's a veteran, many, many years in that ring. Brandon P., though, coming back from that injury, we'll see. We'll see what he can do.
Well, that shoulder's not really showing any signs of fatigue so far. But the match continues, and a headbutt from Mr. Wrestling number 4 doing some damage to himself there, knocking himself a little loopy, but now looking for a belly-to-back suplex, but no, Brandon P.Net flips through. And folks, we're going to have to take a commercial break. We'll be back in just a moment.
Do you have what it takes to become a pro wrestler? The APW Bootcamp Training School is accepting applicants for pro wrestlers, managers, valets, and referees. All Pro Wrestling, home of APW Bootcamp, is where future legends are born. For the last 19 years, APW has been the leader in talent development. Top graduates include The Great Khali, Crash Holly, Spike Dudley, and Alyssa Flash. For your free brochure, call us at 510-785-8396.
And we're back here, a cover from BrandonP.net, the internet sensation, only gets the two.
It's been back and forth throughout the entire commercial break. Nobody really getting the upper hand on this one. Brandon P. has it now with that sleeper hold locked in on Mr. Wrestling number four. But it's been kind of exciting during the break. I'm sorry people missed it.
Yeah, exactly. You never know what you're gonna see here at All Pro Wrestling. You're never going to be as close to any pro wrestling action as you are here at the world-famous All Pro Wrestling Garage in Hayward, California. A big back elbow for Mr. Wrestling number four, trying to gain some separation. And a chin breaker. Now he's going to grab the ankle. Could he be thinking ankle lock? No, he's going to look for that figure four leg lock.
There's that mask. That mask again of Mr. Wrestling number four adjusted at the last second, giving BrandonP.net the opportunity to kick him off.
Well, the internet sensation, the internet darling here trying to fight back and get the victory here in All Pro Wrestling. It would be one heck of a notch in the belt for BrandonP.net to get a victory over the former worldwide internet champion.
Can you imagine the new Twitter followers from BrandonP.net if he gets a victory over Mr. Wrestling number four? I'll be personally responsible for most of those Twitter followers.
Well, he was looking for a big boot there to the side of the face, but Mr. Wrestling number four saw it coming, and now he's got the figure four leg lock. This move has won so many matches for Mr. Wrestling number four. Is it going to do it here? Is it going to do it here? BrandonP.net trying to fight out.
They're in the center of the ring. Brandon P's got a long way to go before he gets to that bottom rope.
He's crawling, inching towards that bottom rope. Is he going to get to it? Reaching out. In pain. Shoulders to the mat, trying to alleviate some kind of pressure. If he rolls him over, he'll switch the pressure, but instead he grabs the bottom rope, forcing Mr. Wrestling number four to break the hold.
That's good. That's strong. That's tough right there. I can't think of many people that have lasted as long in the figure four as Brandon P did there. Good job, sir. Good job.
Number four looking for a right hand, countered by Brandon. And a right forearm to the face of Mr. Russ number four to that hooded face. Whips him across the ring. Leapfrog by Brandon. Mr. Russ number four with a shot to the gut. Looking for a crucifix backslide. No. Oh!
That's a $1 million knee lift right there, the cover.
Out of nowhere, cover, hook the leg. And he gets it, Mr. Wrestling number four, with the victory here on APW Gym Wars.
And your winner by pinfall at 6 minutes and 36 seconds, Mr. Wrestling number four.
Well, Mr. Wrestling number four hits the $1 million knee lift out of nowhere and gets the victory here in our opening contest.
I certainly didn't see that one coming. Normally comes off of the ropes as this big, big shimmy before he does it, lets everyone know that it's coming, but took me by surprise. Took BrandonP.net by surprise as well. But Brandon P showing a smidgen of ring rust in there, but for the most part, it looks like he's back there 100%. Once he has a couple more matches under his belt, we'll probably see a lot more BrandonP.net here at APW.
Well, it seemed like the shoulder wasn't bothering him too much, and Mr. Wrestler number four helping Brandon back up to his feet, gonna shake his hand, the ultimate sign of respect here in All Pro Wrestling.
That's disgusting. Absolutely. Why did BrandonP.net shake his hand? Should have just clocked him a good one.
I think you're
smart. Make a statement here in APW, BrandonP.net. Punch Mr. Wrestling number four right in the chin.
I think
you'll be talked about for weeks.
I think you're still bitter that Mr. Wrestling number four didn't sign with you and with the All-Stars.
I think I'm bitter that Mr. Wrestling number four punched me in the face. Maybe Mr. Wrestling number four needs to be punched in the face himself many times, every time I see him on the TV show. Did you ever think about that?
Well, you see him here celebrating with the foreheads in the war zone. And a round of applause for Mr. Wrestling number four, the former worldwide internet champion.
Undeserved round of applause.
And a bow in support to these great fans here at the APW Garage. And now getting some photos.
This is making me sick to my stomach.
Photos. And folks, we're going to take a commercial break. When we come back, you're going to see Levi Shapiro in his debut against Vennis DeMarco. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Are you or your son or daughter celebrating a birthday soon? There's no better way to celebrate a birthday than to throw the birthday person a pro wrestling themed birthday party. We have several packages available, including renting our facility with a customized pro wrestling show. Bring your birthday cake and invite your guests to attend a private pro wrestling birthday party. If you are interested in having all pro wrestling be a part of your birthday celebration, give us a call at 510-785-8396 or visit the website at www.allprowrestling.com.
Let me tell you one thing, son. This right here, this is my destiny in professional wrestling. This has been my goal since day one, and I'm going on 10 years, Matt Carlos. That belt will not be around your waist for very long. Trust me on that, because Wrestling Personified is gonna take that title from around your waist here in the near future, if you're man enough to put it on the line against me.
Rick Luxury. You could come in here screaming, hollering, threatening, bullying. All you had to do, Rick, all you had to do was ask. You want that match? As long as the APW committee's down, trust me, I'm down. I'm gonna be a fighting champion just like all the champions before me were. You're on.
That's all I wanted to hear, Carlos. Thank you. Let's go, Mac.
About that APW.
Get in there!
Yeah, no. We know where it's at.
The Romano, right?
Yeah. Same room as always? Okay. We'll pick you up. Thanks. Hi, Carlos.
Commissioner, how's it going?
Good. How are you doing?
I'm all doing all right. You probably already saw that footage of the big celebration after my match with Miss Wrestling number 4 for the internet title. Yeah, it was for me, until it got ruined in the back. I was out there, I was kind of interview, and Rick Luxury and Marcus Mack decided to come in and interrupt it all and destroy the magical moment I was having. And I was hoping if there's anything you could do to help me out in that situation.
Well, Matt Carlos, I mean, I reviewed the footage. I've been going over, you know, the files, and what I have here in my hand is the contract. And definitely, we're going to have you sign this. I'm going to have Rick Luxury sign this. He reigns on your parade, and I know you're going to be a fighting champion. So, definitely. I'm definitely going to have this sign. You're going to have your match. All right? I put the OK stamp of approval on it, and we're getting this thing booked.
Thank you.
No problem.
Commissioner, thank you. Hey. I really want this title match to happen. Thank you.
I know you're going to be a stand-up champion. Thank you, Matt Carlos.
Thank you.
Double or nothing.
That's
a hell of a
move.
Hey,
Matt.
Hey, guys.
Hey, we know about your big match with Rick Luxury. We know Marcus Mack is going to be out there. You know, Dave and I, we can go out there for your match and support you. You know, we can make sure Marcus Mack doesn't do anything out there.
Yeah. You know, I appreciate it. I love the fact that you guys are there for me and the fact that you guys got my back. But honestly, for my first title defense, for my first big title defense, I think I need to do this one on my own.
All right. Well, we're pulling for you. We know you can do it. Just remember, too, okay, I want that title. I still have a rematch. Rematch clause. So, you know, I hope you win and I can get that title shot.
Well, after I get my revenge on Rick Luxury, you'll be the first in line.
All right, then.
You guys ready to go eat?
Let's do it. Let's go do it, man.
Let's go.
And we're back here in All Pro Wrestling Gym Wars, folks, and it's time to see the debut here in APW of Levi Shapiro.
Now, I've heard a lot about this Levi Shapiro. He's been making quite a stir in the West Coast of pro wrestling. Been seen around California, up and down, see what he can do here at All Pro Wrestling. Levi Shapiro. I think he's Jewish. I'm not sure. I think he is.
Making his way to the ring first. From beautiful Atlantic City, New Jersey, weighing in at 205 pounds, Levi Shapiro.
Well, this young man making his way all the way from Atlantic City out on the East Coast, coming out here to California, trying to make a name for himself here in the world-famous All-Pro Wrestling Garage.
Now, I was talking to Snooki the other day. She's from New Jersey as well. You know, if he's from New Jersey, and he's such a person like Snooki, maybe he'll win today.
Is he going to fist bump?
And the bump is silly.
Well, here he is, the Italian Superman, making his way down to ringside. Vennis DeMarco, the fan favorite here in APW.
Vennis DeMarco. I used to have a lot of respect for Vennis DeMarco. He's a two-time tag team champion, part of the Mafia with Chris Colleoni. And now what does he do? He comes out, he parades around, he throws his fingers in the air, he cheers, he chants, everyone likes him, they scream for him, he's happy, they're happy, everyone's happy. It makes me sick.
Well, don't forget, folks, you too can be happy here at the All Pro Wrestling Jim Moore's TV tapings. Don't forget to log on to www.allprowrestling.com for all future information about all future dates, as well as any information about All Pro Wrestling.
Now, of the little bit that I've seen of Levi Shapiro so far, I'm really impressed. Did you see those style and sunglasses that he had on his face? I need to find out from him where he got those. I need a pair for myself.
Well, you see referee Toby going over the rules here with Vennis DeMarco and Levi Shapiro. Folks, you saw during the commercial break, today's main event was signed. It's going to be Matt Carlos for the first time defending his APW Worldwide Internet Championship against wrestling personified Rick Luxury.
Don't forget my very good friend in Rick Luxury's corner, Marcus Mack. Marcus Mack is going to be there cheering his guy on. It's going to be great.
And speaking of Marcus Mack, you saw when Matt Carlos came out of JJ Perez's office, all of his friends were there. They were waiting to hear the news from him when he told them, it's going to happen. They said, we're going to be out there. We're going to have your back. And he said, no, I'm doing this by myself. It's my first title defense. I'm going to go out. I'm going to defend the title by myself.
Okay. Good luck, Matthew Carlos. Good luck. That's all I have to say.
Will Shapiro shooting DeMarco across the ring. No, countered by DeMarco. And now big back body drop sends Shapiro up into the lights.
Wow.
And a drop toe hold from DeMarco takes him back down to his face. Floats over now with a front face lock on Levi Shapiro.
That's some intensity from Vennis DeMarco. Honestly, I didn't expect this so early on in the match. Throwing Levi Shapiro 25 feet in the air. That was 25 feet, right?
Roughly so.
But you exaggerator, John Roberts. I can't believe you fell into my trap like that. That was about 25 feet, but that was ridiculously high.
It might as well have been with how high it was. I'm not about to go out there with a tape measure and measure it. You can do that if you like. DeMarco with a front face lock now. Now turns it into a side headlock in the center of the ring. He's got Shapiro right where he wants him.
Shapiro fighting back, though. Shapiro realizes that this is his first dance here at APW. This is all pro wrestling. This is the pinnacle of pro wrestling. This is where you want to be, John Roberts. He needs to pull out a huge victory against someone like the veteran Vennis DeMarco.
Well, he hits him with a spinning heel kick there. Goes for the cover. One, two. Only gets two. So close to getting a three count there. Folks, we're going to step away for just a moment as we see Shapiro with the choke. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Dropping it down hard. One, two. Kick out. I have never seen anything like that before. Wow. Wow, is all I can say. This match is taking my breath away. What a great matchup on display here on All Pro Wrestling Jim Moore.
All Pro Wrestling Jim Moore on the Bay Area's KFTY TV 50 Digital 199 and KAZV 14 Digital 195 in the Central Valley. We'll see you Saturday morning at 11 a.m. for All Pro Wrestling Jim Moore.
And we're back, folks. During the commercial break, Levi Shapiro maintaining control over the veteran Vennis DeMarco, and now a rake of the face with those laces on his wrestling boot. I'm joined, as always, by my broadcast colleague, Matthew Theault, the self-proclaimed greatest mind in professional wrestling.
Close enough. That's probably the best I'm going to get out of you, so I'm just going to go ahead and accept it. But look at the viciousness right here of Levi Shapiro in his grand debut here at APW, showing the fire in his heart, showing exactly who he is in the ring. You know, there's no dancing, there's no parading. He's been there, he's being vicious, chops to the chest, stomps on the ground. He's showing Vennis DeMarco exactly who he is, and he's showing all of these people, all these dumb morons outside the ring, exactly what Levi Shapiro is all about, and I personally love it.
Well, the young man fighting out of Atlantic City, bringing it to the Italian Superman here in APW in his debut. Right hands in the corner, and now he's going to choke him out in the middle of the rope, showing his face right to the fans in the front row of the War Zone.
Making sure the War Zone knows the face and knows the viciousness of Levi Shapiro. What a vicious name. Levi Shapiro.
Well, a big right arm to the back of Shapiro knocks him down. DeMarco gets back in control of this match. And a right hand to the face has Shapiro reeling into the rope. Gonna shoot him off across. No, counter by Shapiro. DeMarco hits the rope. Big clothesline takes him down. And now Shapiro back in control. Grabbing a handful of the hair, trying to bring DeMarco back up to his feet. Does just that. And a rake of the eyes. DeMarco can't see. He's kind of wandering, just strolling around the ring, trying to get his bearings back.
He's lost where he's at. That's what happens when he can't see. Able to connect a couple of fists on Levi Shapiro, though. But Shapiro hammering back with his own, able to get Vennis DeMarco down.
And a very arrogant cover there from the rookie. And DeMarco kicks out at one. You know, maybe if he drops down, he gets maybe a two count there. Instead, only gets the one. And a snapmare out of the corner. And now he's going to grab a sleeper hold. He's got to be careful he doesn't put that arm against the throat too much. Otherwise, he's going to get called for a choke there, an illegal choke. But it looks like he's technically sound there with that sleeper. DeMarco's going to try to fight out here, getting back to his feet. He's got one foot up, and he's getting back to the second one now, trying to fight out the crowd. Soundly behind DeMarco as he's fighting his way out of that. Oh, but countered by Shapiro.
And Shapiro grabbed a handful of Vennis DeMarco's hair and pulled him to the mat. That's what you got to do in situations like that. Vennis DeMarco's trying to mount a comeback. Levi Shapiro is there to stop him cold in his tracks.
Hits the rope, big leg drop. Goes for a cover, doesn't hook the leg, only gets the two. Nice lateral press, but if he hooks the leg, possible three count there and possible victory in his debut here in All Pro Wrestling.
That would be incredible.
But he's got a sleeper hold applied once again. Going to try to put DeMarco to sleep. Going to try to knock him out in the center of the ring. And it looks like he's starting to do just that. DeMarco's starting to show signs of fatigue.
5 minutes.
As we hear 5 minutes elapsed in this contest. The crowd once again trying to will DeMarco on. Is he going to be able to get to his feet? He does so here. Right elbow to the gut. No counter by Shapiro. Scoop and a slam
down,
puts DeMarco on
body slam there by Levi Shapiro. Vennis DeMarco, he's out of sorts right now. A couple of sleeper holds, a big body slam right there in the middle of the ring. Levi Shapiro coming up to the top rope. What's he got planned here?
Well, looks like he's going to fly. Looking for the big drop kick. Nobody home. DeMarco moves out of the way. Sidestep, and now he's going to go outside. Going to look for that big kick right across the throat. That
right
sent
across the face.
Cover hooked the leg. Only gets two.
Welcome to All Pro Wrestling, Levi Shapiro. Ouch.
Well, it would look like Levi Shapiro has done his homework before coming out here. He found out he was going to be facing Vennis DeMarco. Probably studied some old tapes of him, and you've seen it in use here. He's done his homework. He's fighting hard, trying to get a victory here in his debut. But DeMarco back in control of this contest. Right hand in the corner from DeMarco. Gonna whip him across the ring here. Countered once again by Shapiro. Hard into the turnbuckle goes DeMarco. And a fisherman suplex there.
Yeah, you don't see that too often.
Cover, hook and leg, one. This could be a two. Oh, about a half a second away from the three count. And he thought he had it. The young man from New Jersey thought he had the three count there.
Big fisherman suplex. That is a move, John Roberts. That is a fantastic suplex maneuver.
A shot to the gut from DeMarco and a DDT out of nowhere. Probably a desperation DDT. Gonna get back to his feet. Gonna try to fire up.
Trying to go for that face spank. He's got it. He's got it. Face spank right there in the middle of the ring.
He's just gotta roll him over. Having trouble doing so. Can he get it here? Hook of the leg. One, two. Gets the three.
Shapiro's foot hit the rope there at the last.
And the winner at 6 minutes and 59 seconds. Vennis DeMarco!
I'm going to have a conversation with referee Toby and the ring announcer here about Levi Shapiro's foot there on the rope at the last set. What do you think about that?
You know, it looked like his foot might have hit the rope there, but in any event, the ref didn't see it, and the ref's call is going to stand for now. Maybe if someone would like to file a protest with the commissioner?
I might have to think about filing a protest on behalf of Levi Shapiro.
Does this mean that he could possibly be part of the All-Star?
The All-Stars. Make sure you say it right, John Roberts. Yeah, you know, whatever. My own head. First match here at APW. He didn't come up with a victory. But, you know, look at Vennis DeMarco, the veteran. The veteran Vennis DeMarco.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, don't go anywhere. Our big main event's coming up. Worldwide internet title on the line. Matt Carlos, his first title defense against wrestling personified Rick Luxury.
Are you or your son or daughter celebrating a birthday soon? There's no better way to celebrate a birthday than to throw the birthday person a pro wrestling themed birthday party. We have several packages available, including renting our facility with a customized pro wrestling show. Bring your birthday cake and invite your guests to attend a private pro wrestling birthday party. If you are interested in having all pro wrestling be a part of your birthday celebration, give us a call at 510-785-8396 or visit the website at www.allprowrestling.com.
And we're back, folks, here for our main event as we see the challenger is on his way out here, wrestling personified Rick Luxury, and no doubt he will be joined by his manager, the no alternate pink mink of professional wrestling, Marcus Mack.
Is he not the self-proclaimed no alternate pink mink of professional wrestling?
I reserve that phrase just for you.
Wow. Matthew, by the way. Matthew Theon. And there he is, the challenger. Wrestling personified Rick Luxury and his manager, the no alternate pink maker professional wrestler.
Well, the flamboyant one, the wrestling personified Rick Luxury making his way out here. You never know what he's going to do with his hair today. He's got it slicked back, looking like a greaser almost. But coming out to the ring, he's definitely got his A game on every time he steps through those ring ropes.
Well-deserved flamboyance. If you are the caliber of wrestler that Rick Luxury is, you can wear feather boas. You can have fun hairstyles. And you can wear, what do you call those glasses? Those awesome, awesome glasses he has on his face.
I believe the term is, yes, stunishing.
Stunna shades for Rick Luxury. And now, look. Look how good that ring announcer is now. Look how great Donovan Troy looks with that feather boa and the stunna shades.
Well, some words from Wrestling Personified. And he's telling Matt Carlos, I'm walking out with that worldwide internet championship.
It's entirely possible. Rick Luxury has won numerous championships up and down the West Coast. It just could be another one here. The internet championship on the line against out of control Matt Carlos. I'm getting to wear the belt.
Well, here comes the champ. Out of control. That, like I said, when he won the title, the worldwide internet championship has definitely gone out of control. And Matt Carlos is getting set for his first title defense here in All Pro Wrestling. Folks, don't forget, you can see all the matches from Matt Carlos here in All Pro Wrestling, as well as numerous matches from Wrestling Personified Rick Luxury on www.youtube.com/AllProWrestling.
And, of course, we're on Twitter, twitter.com/AllProWrestling. Read all the latest news, everything you ever wanted to know about AEW.
Well, Matt Carlos sliding into the ring, and you see him telling his fans, telling the Matt Carlos movement here at ringside, I'm walking out with this internet title. Let's go down to Donovan Troy for the introductions for this worldwide internet title contest.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is scheduled for one fall with a 30-minute time limit, and it's for the All Pro Wrestling Worldwide Internet Championship. The referee for this contest, Sparky Beller. Introducing first, the challenger, with his manager, Marcus Mack, from Sin City, Nevada, weighing at 214.25 pounds. He is trained at the PCW Work Farm. He is also a former PCW Heavyweight Champion, a two-time NorCal Outstanding Wrestler of the Year, also a two-time NorCal Wrestler of the Year, the 2008 NorCal Wrestler of the Year, APW Wrestler of the Year, and also... He is also the next APW Worldwide wrestling personified, Rick Luxury. And his opponent from Union City, California, weighing in at 173 pounds, he is the master of the Union Landing in the white, and he is the All-Pro Wrestling Worldwide Internet Champion. He's out of control, Matt Carlos.
All right, folks. Well, the war zone is rocking. We're all set for this main event contest here on All-Pro Wrestling Gym Wars. I'm excited. Matt, are you excited for this contest?
Matthew, my name is Matthew, and yes, I am excited. I'm excited to see wrestling personified Rick Luxury win the Worldwide Internet Championship.
Well, those are strong words from you, strong words from Rick Luxury before this contest, and a slap to the face reminiscent of the punch heard round the world in the locker room. Folks, we'll be right back with this main event.
Do you have what it takes to become a pro wrestler? The APW Bootcamp Training School is accepting applicants for pro wrestlers, managers, valets, and referees. All Pro Wrestling, home of APW Bootcamp, is where future legends are born. For the last 19 years, APW has been the leader in talent development. Top graduates include The Great Khali, Crash Holly, Spike Dudley, and Alyssa Flash. For your free brochure, call us at 510-785-8396.
And we're back here on All Pro Wrestling Gym Wars. Matt Carlos starting to show signs of frustration, having words with Marcus Mack at ringside as Rick Luxury keeps getting in the ring and then he gets back out of the ring, not letting Matt Carlos wrestle the match that he wants to wrestle.
Proper freaking great strategy by wrestling personified Rick Luxury and my close personal friend Marcus Mack, trying to frustrate young Matthew Carlos to a point where he can't see straight. All he sees is red. He wants to rip Rick Luxury apart and he can't do it. He can't do it because Rick Luxury keeps on leaving the ring. Perfect.
Well, finally, we see a collar and elbow tie in the center of the ring, and it immediately goes right into the turnbuckle as Luxury and Carlos roll all the way across the ropes to the crumble, and a slap from Carlos to the face of Luxury. Now right hands, that's got to be retribution, and a drop kick knocks Luxury to the outside. Retribution for the slap before the match, and the punch heard round the world.
But you see him. You see how frustrated Matthew Carlos is. He cannot wait to get his hands on Rick Luxury, and all that's going to do is to take his eyes off of the game. He's going to be too focused on trying to hurt Rick Luxury, too focused on revenge instead of focused on keeping his championship.
Well, it just brought Rick Luxury back into the ring. I don't think it was the way that Luxury planned on, but Wrestling Personified in trouble here early on in this contest. Big clothesline from Carlos takes down Wrestling Personified, and instead of going for a cover here, he's gonna get top mount position and big right hands to the face of Rick Luxury.
There we go. Again, that's the frustration showing on Matthew Carlos. If he were to try for a cover or slap on a submission, he might be in a better position to win this match. But instead, he wants to punish Rick Luxury, which is the wrong way to go about it because he's just playing right into Luxury's hands.
Well, out of control with a couple of European uppercuts. They're losing his balance, but now with the side headlock takeover, and he's got that side headlock still applied in the center ring, and a handful of hair there by Luxury. But Carlos soundly in control over Wrestling Personified early on in this contest. Don't forget, folks, this is for that prestigious Worldwide Internet Championship. Perhaps the most prestigious title in all of professional wrestling. Matt Carlos in control there, taking over Wrestling Personified.
Yeah, Matthew Carlos has settled down a little bit. He's gained his composure, maybe come back a little bit into control, which is good. But Rick Luxury, again, showing his mental game. His head is in this match, John Roberts. He is so focused on becoming the next Worldwide Internet Champion, and it is showing in every move that he makes.
Well, the internet title, the one title that seems to have eluded Rick Luxury throughout his historic 9-year career here in professional wrestling in this great sport. But now a cover by Matt Carlos, straight jacket into a roll up there. Beautiful, beautiful roll up by Matt Carlos. And now a double clothesline, both men down center of the ring.
This is where all the momentum changes. Matthew Carlos is able to get that quick straight jacket roll up, something I did not see coming. That's Matthew Carlos showing his out of control nature for sure.
And a right hand from Matt Carlos has Rick Luxury reeling as he sends him back into that corner. You see Rick Luxury's manager, Marcus Mack, grabbing the briefcase off the apron, perhaps afraid that maybe Matt Carlos might use it. I don't see that happening. But a big crossbody as he jumps off the second rope there, only gets a two count, almost three, almost had a retention of the Worldwide Internet Championship.
I can speak from personal experience that Marcus Mack removed that briefcase because he doesn't want referee Sparky Bowler to get confused to think that Rick Luxury might have used the briefcase. He doesn't want Rick Luxury to lose this match as a result of a disqualification, because as we know, disqualification means the title stays on the current champion.
Well, Rick Luxury in trouble, but he's able to get that left foot over to the bottom rope, which forces Matt Carlos to break the hold, and the challenger able to elude possibly losing this match right there. But now he's going to counter Carlos as he gets set to whip him across the ring. As he shoots on the rope, drops down at a big right hand from Rick Luxury. Classic Rick Luxury right there, wrestling personified, showing you what his veteran know-how has taught him over these last 9 years here in this sport of kings.
Well put. I'll have to give credit where credit was due. That was very nice, John Roberts. Good job.
Rick Luxury, the challenger here in this contest, fighting for that prestigious purple belt, the Worldwide Internet Championship, throws Matt Carlos to the outside, and now it looks like he's distracting referee Sparky Bowler in the right boot from Marcus Mack. Those $900 Italian leather shoes of Marcus Mack right in the face of Matt Carlos.
Making sure that Matt Carlos remembers that Marcus Mack is there, providing the distraction that Rick Luxury needs to make sure that he stays on top in this incredible championship match. So far, Rick Luxury has been on his A game.
Well, now these two fighting out here in the war zone. Matt Carlos jumps back up onto the apron. Could he be thinking Satan? No! Big right boot to the face sends Luxury hard onto his back on the cement floor here in the war zone. The garage is rocking and rolling here tonight, folks. This has been one heck of a matchup.
Matthew Carlos making sure that Marcus Mack rather stays out of the way. Matt Carlos moving Rick Luxury back in, trying to get the pin, trying to get the legitimate win over Rick Luxury. Have to question that. He would retain the championship on a count out just the same as if he pinned his shoulders to the mat.
Well, only able to get the two count there. Drops a couple of knees across the throat of Rick Luxury. Now he's going to go up to that second rope. Looking like he's going to drop a big fist, and he does so, out of control, flying off the second rope. Could this be it here? Gets two? No, only two. And Matt Carlos, the champion, in control of this contest in the early going, but now he gets cut off by wrestling personified Rick Luxury. Folks, don't go anywhere. This main event match continues as soon as we come back.
Are you or your son or daughter celebrating a birthday soon? There's no better way to celebrate a birthday than to throw the birthday person a pro wrestling themed birthday party. We have several packages available, including renting our facility with a customized pro wrestling show. Bring your birthday cake and invite your guests to attend a private pro wrestling birthday party. If you are interested in having all pro wrestling be a part of your birthday celebration, give us a call at 510-785-8396 or visit the website at www.allprowrestling.com.
We are back. All Pro Wrestling Jim Moore's main event Worldwide Internet Championship is on the line as out of control Matthew Carlos defends the title against wrestling personified Rick Luxury. I am Matthew Thiel, the greatest mind in professional wrestling. This is John Roberts, my broadcast lackey. And throughout the entire commercial break, Rick Luxury has been in control of this match. He had a couple of near falls. He almost took it home time and time again. See if he can pull it through this time.
Will Rick Luxury calling for the big knee to the spine of Matt Carlos there instead drops down and tricks everybody, puts in a sleeper hold in the center of the ring. Could this be the matchup? Could Rick Luxury do something you don't really see that often in pro wrestling anymore? Win a match with a bona fide wrestling maneuver. Could he be putting Matt Carlos to sleep right here?
Matthew Carlos is fading.
He's fading fast. The signs of fatigue from throughout this great title matchup show him, but he's trying to fight back, trying to use every ounce of energy that is being thrown his way from the Matt Carlos movement, and he, with a desperation move right there, does a jawbreaker, and now a quick roll-up. Could he get the three count here? One, two, almost three, only gets the two, and this match continues. A dropkick right on the money. Matt Carlos, a second one for good measure. He's got to crawl towards the cover, does so, hooks the outside leg. One, two, almost three, about 2 7/8. Matt Carlos was that close to walking out of here, still the worldwide internet champion.
And you can see the difference in Matthew Carlos's attitude here. He's gone from being fueled by his anger and his frustration with wrestling personified. Now he's getting back down to the basics, back down to the science, trying to wrestle his way, throwing drop kicks, trying to use his pro wrestling training he's received at the APW boot camp to try to retain that championship. I think it's a good change.
Well, a big elbow to the neck by Rick Luxury after grabbing a handful of the tights and throwing Matt Carlos face first into that second turnbuckle. And a blatant choke, a blatant disrespect to the rules by wrestling personified. And he looks, you see the look in his eye, you see the look in his face. He looked up towards Sparky Ballard like he hadn't done anything wrong. A childlike look of innocence in the eyes of wrestling personified Rick Luxury.
In the heat of the moment during a championship match like this, maybe he didn't do anything wrong. He's trying to create opportunities, trying to slow down the unpredictable style of Matthew Carlos. I really can't blame him.
Well, Matt Carlos ducks the clothesline, rolling through, and now he's got a full Nelson applied in the center of the ring, trying to possibly beat Rick Luxury with a wrestling move of his own here. Luxury trying to fight out, trying to break the grip of Matt Carlos, but to no avail. And now a full Nelson suplex across the ring drops Rick Luxury on his neck.
Surprising. Matthew Carlos isn't known for his strength and his size, normally for his speed and his unpredictability.
Looking for the three, only gets the two, so close to retaining the title, but the match continues. Matt Carlos thought he had the match won there. Looking at this referee, Sparky Ballard saying, really is only two, but I'll keep going, and he's going to keep fighting for that internet title.
Matthew Carlos really has Rick Luxury reeling at this point. Rick Luxury doesn't seem to know where he is. He can barely stand. Matthew Carlos going behind. Maybe a German suplex, perhaps. I don't know. Ah, there we go. There's the wisdom. How dare I doubt wrestling personified Rick Luxury? He had everything in control the whole time.
Well, Rick Luxury grabbing a handful of Sparky Ballard's jersey and a shot to the groin of Matt Carlos. While distracting the referee, he gains the upper hand. Only gets two that time. Thought he had three. Thought he had the match won.
10 minutes.
And 10 minutes have gone by in this main event matchup. John Roberts and Matthew Thiel here at the world famous All Pro Wrestling Garage. It's Matt Carlos putting the internet title on the line against wrestling personified Rick Luxury as Luxury goes hard into that turnbuckle. A big splash in the corner from out of control Matt Carlos.
Matthew Carlos trying to get the movement behind him, going up to this questionable strategy again. He's primed himself. Look, he slipped off the middle rope there. That high risk name. Oh. Sparky Ballard caught this in the middle sandwich. Sparky Ballard.
It looked like Rick Luxury once again grabbed a handful of the jersey of Sparky Ballard and brought him in between him and out. Out comes referee Toby. You see the briefcase got thrown in there, but Luxury said, no, I don't want it. Threw it out of the way.
You saw referee Toby right out there.
Well, looking for the clothesline, but Carlos ducks it. Looking for the union landing. Could this be it? No,
wrestling Luxury personified scouted it out perfectly, able to get out of the grip for the union landing.
Well, stalking him like a shark sends his blood in the water. Backstabber, he's got him rolled up. Could this be it? New Inter Champion, 1, 2, 3. Luxury's done it in his 9-year career. He has won the Internet Championship
by pinfall at 11 minutes and 4 seconds. And the new All Pro Wrestling Worldwide Internet Champion!
Well, we were about to call... Referee Sparky Ballard calling for a new start of the match.
By orders of the official, this match will continue!
Union landing, Matt Carlos springboarding off of Marcus Mack. This match restarted. Cover hook of the leg, gets the three count, and Matt Carlos retains!
And the winner by pinfall at 11 minutes and 13 seconds, and still APW Worldwide Internet Champion out of control, Matt Carlos.
What was that, John Roberts? Referee Toby is an officially licensed official here at APW. He has the authorization to count shoulders to the match to the count of three. I don't understand. Rick Luxury should be the worldwide internet champion right now. This is completely ridiculous.
Well, I think if I'm reading the body language correct from when Sparky Ballard and Toby started talking, it seemed like Sparky was telling him, no, I know Rick Luxury grabbed my jersey, pulled me in between him and Matt Carlos, and therefore I'm going to restart this match. almost as a way of disqualifying Rick Luxury and giving him a new match. But in any event, Matt Carlos is still the Worldwide Internet Champion, retaining the title, hitting the Union Landing off of the back of wrestling personified Rick Luxury's manager, the no alternate Pink Mink, Marcus Mack.
I am so angry right now, John Roberts. I can't believe Sparky Ballard went out of his way like that to screw Rick Luxury out of the championship. How many times is Rick Luxury going to be screwed out of the Worldwide Internet Championship right here at APW in front of my eyes?
Well, folks, that's all the time we have for this week. On behalf of my broadcast colleague, Matthew Thiel, and everyone here at All Pro Wrestling, John Roberts saying so long till next week.